Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Morning Tales for June 11, 2019. And the questions here, I'll be discussing about the new awards which have been announced related to yoga. We'll be discussing about the most punctual airlines and which country is the third in the world to launch the rocket from CPAD. Now let's begin with the first question, and before beginning with the question, let me just tell you that we are providing 10 mocks of phase 1 and 5 mocks of phase 2. And the price of that, those mocks are ₹999. So the gross amount is 1500, and after using the coupon code MOCKS, that is MOCKS, you can avail the discount and get these mocks, these 15 mocks for ₹999. Now let's begin with the first question. So the first question says, which of the following ministry has instituted new awards called the Antarrashtriya Yoga Divas Media Samman? Now these awards, Antarrashtriya Yoga Divas Media Samman. Now two ministries could be the answer of this question, that if it is involving yoga, and another thing, it is involving media as well. So from yoga, it might seem that the Ministry of Ayush has inaugurated or instituted these new awards, but the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting has constituted these new awards known as the Antarrashtriya Yoga Divas Media Samman. Now, what are these awards and what is the purpose of these awards? So, the government has decided to honor the media houses. Basically, what media houses? The newspaper organizations, the TV and the radio channels. Whoever is creating or contributing towards creating awareness about the yoga. So this is the purpose, and there will be 33 awards. Each would be given in the three categories. One to the, that is 11 in each categories. So 11 for the newspaper organizations, 11 for the TV channels, and 11 for the radio channels. So this is the constitution of this Antarrashtriya Yoga Divas Media Samman Award. Now the question arises, a static question, and that you need to mention in the comment section below. It's the easiest question if we talk about the important days for June. So International Day of Yoga is observed on which date? So you need to mention that in the comment section below, that on which day we observe this International Day of Yoga. Let's move on to the next question. So the next question is, Dash is the newly approved pension cover scheme. So as I told you in the previous video as well, on the first day of cabinet meeting, there were various changes made in the cabinet's committees as well and various schemes as well. One of the scheme was the Kisan Samman Nidhi Yojana, and that scheme has been expanded, or all the farmers would be included under that scheme now. Now this is one of the new central sector scheme which has been launched by the, or which has been now approved, basically approved by the cabinet, and it involves the pension, or it is the pension cover scheme. What is the name of the scheme? So the name is Pradhan Mantri Kisan Pension Yojana. Very easy, PMKPY. So as the name suggests, they would be providing pension covers to the farmers, and this is the voluntary and contributory pension scheme, both for the small and marginal farmers. So the voluntary and contributory pension scheme for small and marginal farmers, if the question comes related to it, so it's the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Pension Yojana, where the eligibility is 18 to 40 years of age with provision of minimum fixed pension of ₹3,000 on attaining the age of 60 years. So what factual data you need to remember in this question, that it's the voluntary and contributory scheme. It is eligible for, the people who are eligible should be between 18 to 40 years of age. It is applicable to small and marginal farmers, and ₹3,000 would be provided, the minimum pension would be provided after attaining 60 years of age. So this is what the basics of these, or the guidelines of this Pradhan Mantri Kisan Pension Yojana is. It's important to remember, as it's been approved by the cabinet. Once the officials or the official document is uploaded, we'll discuss about this scheme in detail. Moving on to the next question. So which of the following is the most punctual airline as per the analysis done by the flight stats? So there is a portal, flightstats.com, which has found out that the Sri Lankan Airlines is the most punctual airline, with approximately 90.75% of the flights arriving on time. So it's kind of good news that approximately 91%, if we can take that 91% of the flights arrive on time, on the Sri Lankan or through the Sri Lankan Airlines. And this is the second time in less than 12 months that the Sri Lankan has Sri Lankan Airlines has achieved this milestone. Nothing much to discuss in this question, but Sri Lankan Airlines have been declared as the most punctual airline. Remember this thing. The next question is, Dash created the foreign exchange trading platform for retail participants. Now, if we can say that RBI is just functioning at its best, or there are various provisions, there are various committees, various regulations which have been released by RBI, and they all are important with respect to the examination. So they have come up with the new committees which have been formed for different provisions. I've also discussed about those. They removed the RTGS and NEFT charges, that also we have discussed. They've also provided or come up with the new framework for the stressed asset resolution. So these all are something which needs to be studied with respect to RBI. Now RBI has created the foreign exchange trading platform, or they have decided to launch this foreign exchange trading platform for retail participants. So the answer for this question is, RBI is planning to launch this foreign exchange trading platform for retail investors. And another question which can be formed from this question is, who has developed this retail trading platform? So it has been developed by the Clearing Corporation of India, CCIL. So this was announced as the part of the bi-monthly monetary policy which was released by RBI. So to ensure that there is fair and transparent pricing for users of foreign exchange, RBI has planned to come up with this foreign exchange trading platform for retail participants. It might seem that SEBI has announced it, but the answer is RBI. So the next question is, which ministry launched the Swachh Sarvekshan 2020 League? Now this Swachh Sarvekshan League or 2020 League is very important with respect to the examination. The question can come on this. Now the question is asking about the ministry which has launched the Swachh Sarvekshan 2020 League. Now what is this? First of all, what is this Swachh Sarvekshan 2020 League? The important thing is, as the word suggests, Swachh, it is the cleanliness drive for the towns and cities. So this means that this framework would be basically conducted in three quarters, that is April to June, July to September and October to December. So April to June, July to September and October to December. And it will have a weightage of approximately 2000 marks for each quarter. So which will be updated, or which would be evaluated on the basis of the monthly updation of that Swachh Bharat Mission Urban. So there would be 12 service level progress indicators, and the ranks would be assigned in two categories. What are these two categories? The first one is the cities with a population of 1 lakh and above, and another with a population of less than 1 lakh. So these are the two categories in which the awards would be given. Now coming to the ministry which has launched. So as I just told you that the data would be evaluated on the Swachh Bharat Mission Urban. So now it's clear that the Ministry of Housing and Urban Poverty Alleviation, they would be launching, or they have launched this Swachh Sarvekshan 2020 League. It's important because there was this question regarding the which city was actually declared as the cleanest city. So these have been calculated with respect to the Swachh Bharat Mission. As Swachh Bharat Mission is important, similarly Swachh Sarvekshan League 2020 is also important. Next question is, which country has become the third nation in the world to launch the rocket from CPAC? So first of all, there are three countries, Russia, China and US. So these three countries have become, or these three are the countries which have successfully demonstrated the satellite launching from the floating platform. So recently China has launched this rocket which is being named as the Long March 11. Long March 11 is the name of the rocket, which has been launched from the platform which is in Yellow Sea. And this is for the first time that China has launched the rocket from the CPAD or the floating platform. Earlier, Russia and US were the only countries which have demonstrated the same. Next question, and quite important question, with which country has India signed a deal to buy 100 spice bombs? So Indian Air Force has actually signed a deal, a 300 crore deal, with the Israeli government. So with Israel, India has signed this 300 crore deal where they would be buying as many as 100 spice bombs. Now this each letter of spy stands for something. So S stands for smart, P precise, E I impact, C cost, and E is effective. So smart, precise, impact, cost effective, this is the name of the bombs. This is the full name of the bomb. So the newly ordered these spice bombs are an advanced version of the spice 2000. So it's important to remember the different deals which are being conducted between the defense of our country with the other countries. Now it's time for you to mention your answers in the comment section. So where is this Mount Sinabung located? Why is this Mount Sinabung in news? So I'll tell you the reason behind this. So this Mount Sinabung recently erupted in the Sumatra Islands. One more hint I have given regarding this question. So from the Sumatra Island, this has erupted, and therefore this Mount Sinabung is in news nowadays. So you need to tell me in the comment section in which country is this Mount Sinabung located. Also, we have launched the May Spotlight. You can just visit the website www.anujindal.in, where you can find the link for the monthly current affairs and you can download the May Spotlight. Also, do not forget to subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon. So once you press the bell icon, you will be receiving the notification as and when the video is being posted. So do not forget to press the bell icon and stay tuned for the next video. Thank you so much for watching the video.